Hello dear learners, in our previous videos of this course, we discussed the names of some learning management systems like Blackboard, Canvas, Google Classroom and Moodle. Today we'll discuss one LMS out of these, which is Moodle. This module will cover some subtopics under its content like development of Moodle site, adding courses in it, conceptual design, instructional design of an online course, course structure, Moodle cloud registration, Moodle app installation, course and site designing, and developing e-tutorials and working with quadrant 1 of an online course. The learning objectives of this present module are, first, the learners will be able to develop conceptual design of an online course. The learners will be able to register on Moodle Cloud. The learners will be able to install Moodle mobile app. The learners will be able to design basic course structure and instructional design. The learners will be able to design Moodle site and courses on it. The learners will be able to develop e-tutorials and working with quadrant 1 of an online course. See, what are MOOCs? MOOCs are massive open online courses. These can be a fruitful option to cater various issues of higher education in India, like access, equity, and quality. The gross enrollment ratio in higher education is 25% in India, which is far less than the developed nations. In order to make higher education accessible to all, the target group every month, 6 universities and 270 colleges are needed to be opened by the Government of India. MOOCs can act as a panacea over here, and as the ecosystem for technology-enhanced learning is also getting very strong in India, MOOCs can be a fruitful option in this regard. One way of implementing MOOCs in teaching learning environment in schools, institutions and universities is that MOOCs can be run at the institutional level. The teachers are here to only assign students to different courses which are not created by themselves but by someone else in the institution. In this system, students learn those things which he learn in other learning environment of an online course in addition to his teacher's classroom. Their knowledge gets enriched and they get opportunity to learn with multiple other resources in addition to the resources of the classroom. Moreover, in such system, students can interact with students all over the world with different socio-cultural backgrounds. Another way of implementation of MOOCs in teaching learning environment is that classroom teacher himself plan, design, develop and deliver online course and enroll his students in his online course developed by himself. The course content can be developed by the teacher as reference material and further supported by the licensed educational resources available free of cost over the internet in the form of supplementary material. These developed MOOCs by the teacher can be delivered in 100% online mode, blended mode or in flipped mode. Nowadays, there are many platforms available which can be utilized by the institutions or the teachers to design, develop and deliver MOOCs. Many learning management systems can be utilized for this purpose, which are available free of cost or on some payment basis. These learning management systems vary in the terms of their ease of use, cost, functionality and their basis in consonance with pedagogical principles. These may be, as we have earlier discussed also, Canvas, Google Classrooms, Blackboard and Moodle. Today we'll be discussing Moodle, which is a very effective LMS. So let us start with Moodle. Let us discuss MOOCs through Moodle. As we discussed some names of learning management systems and Moodle is one of those very effective learning management system, Moodle stands for Modular Object-Oriented Dynamic Learning Environment. It is available free of cost as well as on payment basis. This open source learning management system has been released under general public license. It is based on constructivist pedagogy and social constructionist theory. If we say Moodle is based on constructivist pedagogy, then the underlying philosophy is the learners in Moodle course react and construct their own knowledge by interacting with the wide and varied course content. And if we say Moodle is based on social constructionist theory, and then the underlying philosophy is that in Moodle course, learners and the groups of learners post their content for others to experience. Moodle can be used in a number of ways in teaching learning process, like for flipped classrooms, blended learning, distance learning and many other e-learning situations in educational institutions. Automatic mechanisms are inbuilt in Moodle for developing and delivering high-quality educational content. The first version of Moodle was released on August 20, 2002, and it continued to evolve with the changing concept of online teaching learning methodology. Moodle project is hosted by three countries, USA, Ireland, and Australia. In India, it is coordinated by Moodle headquarters, an Australian company of 50 developers, and it has financial support of 84 Moodle partner service companies all over the world. The latest and updated multimedia tools are already inbuilt in Moodle, and all these tools help the course designers or the teachers to develop the course in the four quadrants of an online course. Moodle is very economic and useful MOOC delivery platform. It helps in developing and delivering online courses with quality. It includes innovative pedagogical features to develop MOOCs. It is available free of cost with some limitations like limited number of users, storage, and other technical aspects. Its paid versions provide huge number of features and are improvisable forms of LMS. Developing MOOCs with Moodle, first step, developing conceptual design for an online course. The development phase of online course with Moodle LMS starts with planning and designing the conceptual design of an online course, which involve framing the course summary template or the course structure as per the content of the course. This course content is to be delivered in the online mode. The sample course template is being shared with you all as an exemplary for the reference. It involves some main points or themes like, first, paper code. You have to write the paper code. Mode, in which mode this course will be delivered, like online or blended. Title of the paper. Type of the paper, whether it is fundamental or elective. Cohort for which it is elective, means for which semester or course you are choosing this course. Cohort for which it is compulsory. Number of credits, like 4 or 2. Semester and year for which this course is being offered. Course coordinator name, prerequisites of the course, what type of basic aptitude or abilities are required from the learners, aim of the course, level, like it is for UG or PG course, and brief description about the modules, learning outcomes of the paper, anticipated learning outcomes will be quoted here, paper evaluation, suggested reading, and then course introductory video link. Now let us start with registering with Moodle Cloud in the form of site creation. For designing an online course with the help of Moodle, the first step for a researcher is to create an account on the Moodle Cloud. Following steps are used for creating an account. First, in main Google browser, type www.moodlecloud.com. Second step, sign up for creating the new account. Then, now click on create a new account and further fill the required details like name, email, age, country, and other details. After filling the details, keep clicking on next and keep further processing for the next steps. And in the last, fill the details of last form and click on the button create my new account. An auto-generated mail will be sent by Moodle to your email. Then the individual need to confirm it by clicking on the provided link that the new account belongs to you. After this confirmation, the new account of Moodle site was generated and it is ready to log in. Homepage creation of the new Moodle created site. After the creation of the Moodle site, you are to design your homepage of the site. The URL of the newly created Moodle site is ready for use. When we are to open this site, enter the specific URL address of your site, like it may be www.rohtak.moodlecloud.com. It may be someone else, some other site also which you have named. After accessing this site, following steps are taken. Enter the username. By default, it is admin for the site created. Then the password of the site is entered from the login section of the main Moodle section, cloud homepage. After login into the newly created Moodle site, home page is designed for which the individual can use already available sample format in Moodle, or the individual can do turn editing on the top right corner of the main site. Then the option add a new course will appear. Then the course developer is to click on add a new course. After clicking on add a new course, fill the required information like course name, starting date of the course, ending date of the course, course code, etc. While filling these details, the course description section will include course write-up and course introductory video. You are to enter your course write-up over here. A half-page write-up is necessary and course introductory video. After filling the details about the course and course summary, the course introductory video can be added under course description, and this video can be made with different softwares like Presentation Tube Recorder, Screencast-O-Matic and some other softwares. The generation of the video tutorials will be discussed over here. The developed video is played, and after playing, click on the right button of the mouse. The option will be like these: copy video URL, copy embed code, or some other options will be there. The developer can upload video file directly to the marked option or can have URL from the YouTube. After uploading this video on YouTube by right clicking the mouse button. This course introductory video should be pasted preferably in embedded code so that it will appear directly on the home page of the site. After filling the necessary marked details and marking the needed changes, click on the button Save and Display. In the end of this phase, the developer can check the necessary changes, whether these are being displayed on the front home page or not. Now, the next step is designing the Moodle site. The Moodle site can be designed by clicking for adding Moodle site name, which will appear on the top of the site, for adding the profile picture, for Moodle site name, and for adding the site introductory video and other necessary details. Following steps may be used. First step is, the course developer is to open the newly created Moodle site by filling the username and the password. Then on the top right corner of the Moodle site, the orange colored button will be there. It will be in the form of inverted triangle. The developer is to click on this button, and after clicking setting button, turn editing on will need to be clicked. Then the developer is to click on edit settings, and then edit profile need to be clicked on. After this, the necessary details are asked by the Moodle site to be filled, in including the site name, short site name, site description, site profile picture, and in the table site description, a small write-up with site introductory video will be added. This site introductory video is supposed to elaborate about the site name, the course under this site, the learners for which this site is being created, the learning objective, and the anticipated learning outcomes after completion of the courses in the site. Now the next phase is developing e-tutorials and working with quadrant 1 of the online course. Developing e-tutorials is the first quadrant of an online course. These are phases for development of any online tutorial. First phase, development of PowerPoint presentation. In the first phase, the PowerPoint presentation of the concept to be presented by the developer is prepared with the help of Microsoft Office PowerPoint presentation. This prepared PowerPoint presentation helps the teacher or the course developer to present the lectures, and this PowerPoint presentation will assist the teacher in focused and objective-directed content delivery during the recording of the lecture with the help of this software. Many themes are already available in Microsoft PowerPoint presentation for development of the presentation. Furthermore, PowerPoint presentation help in holding the attention of the learners apart from proper organization of the content. Second phase will be the recording of the lectures. In the second phase of development of e-tutorials, the lectures are recorded by the teacher or the course developers. Many softwares are available free of cost for developing e-tutorials for recording of the lectures. Some softwares which may be utilized for this purpose are Presentation Tube Recorder, Screencast-O-Matic, Screencastify, AZ Presenter, Active Present, and many other softwares are also available. The course developer may use any of the above mentioned software or may record lectures with the help of the simple camera. Here, we'll discuss one good software, that is Screencast-O-Matic, as an exemplary. Some steps can be used to record lectures by using Screencast-O-Matic. And in the first step, the course developer or the teacher is to download Screencast-O-Matic software from the home page of Screencast-O-Matic. Some sub-steps in this regard can be as, first, open the home page of Screencast-O-Matic screen recorder, http://screencastomatic.com. Second, on this opened homepage, click on the option Start Recording for Free. After clicking on this icon, the windows will switch to the changed window, and in this window, scroll down to the bottom and there will be the icon start recording for free. Then the recorder will start downloading itself. After the complete process of the software downloading, install the software on the desktop or the laptop, and the shortcut of the software can be used by keeping it on the desktop. This software is available free of cost as well as in paid versions. The payment for this paid version can be made online with the help of the card or the net banking. Now this installed software is ready for recording, and following steps can be taken to record lectures by using this software. First step, click on the icon of screen Custom-Matic software installed on your desktop. A pop-up window will appear on the desktop and will show three options. I have a solo plan, I have a team plan, and the launch free recorder. Then the launch free recorder is to be clicked upon. Now the recorder gets ready for recording the lectures. The course developer or the teacher is to first open his PowerPoint presentation which were earlier prepared in the first phase, and is to set this on the slideshow option so that it will appear on your desktop or laptop screen. Then the recorder is to be clicked and recording can be started. After completion of the recording, the course developer has the option to edit the recording or delete the recording, or the option done for saving the recorded lecture. If the recording is over, the option done is to be clicked. Then the software will ask the course developer to save the recorded video file or to publish it in Screencast-O-Matic account or directly to publish on the YouTube. If the course developer is to edit the video, then he can edit the later part of the video from the point where he truncate the recording after keeping and selecting the particular session of the recorded lecture for editing. This is the process of development of e-tutorial, which is the first quadrant of development of an online course. Now let us sum up what we have discussed in this module. Dear learners, today our first video on how to work with Moodle as LMS, we discussed registration with Moodle Cloud, installing Moodle app, designing conceptual design of an online course, designing Moodle site, development of the course, and development of e-tutorials. I hope you enjoyed this session, and for the support of this module and this presentation in the form of lectures, we have recorded some Screencastify video for the practical sessions. Thank you.